last year, 10 years ago. I arrived at 1 a.m. this morning, and in the 10 years that I have been here, I've heard stories about Tanzania's progress, but even in the dark of night, I could see things I didn't see 10 years ago. Secondly, President Mugabe has been out of office for 14 years. I left SADC 25 years ago. So if he's out of touch, I'm a lot more out of touch. But allow me, before responding directly to your questions, to share a few reflections. Firstly, the link between SADC conference and SADC community. The Lusaka Declaration was offered by heads of state and government to the peoples of Southern Africa. And the Vinu Declaration was also offered to the people of Southern Africa. The cause of our efforts and the ultimate purpose of our effort are the people, the peoples of our region. If in nearly 40 years our efforts are not yet touching the everyday lives of our people, then we have a lot of work on our hands. In 1990, we did a documentary to commemorate the 10th anniversary of founding of SADC. And part of the documentary involved talking to so-called ordinary people. And I ran very quickly a conversation between the documentarist and a lady at the Makoni market in Lusaka, example. Went like this. Madam, do you know SADC? Yes. What do you think about it? It's very important. Why do you say that? Because my president goes there every day. Are we any different today? If we went into the streets of Dar es Salaam and asked people who are going about their daily chores, would we get a different answer from that answer in 1990? If yes, congratulations. If not, then we know we have a lot. The second reflection I'd like to share is around integration as contrasted to coordination. SADC conference was about coordinating common efforts. SADC community is about integration. And President Mugabe touched on this theme quite strongly in his presentation. In 1988, we used to offer themes of our work every 1 or 2 years. In 1988, we launched the theme of investment in production. And the focus was to work to establish productive capacities in our economies. And President Kaunda, addressing the SADC summit around this theme, says, our problem is we consume what we don't produce. And we produce what we don't produce. We consume what we don't produce, and we produce what we don't consume. 40 years down the road, as individual countries and as a region, are we countries? That also defines our current challenge. The third reflection I'd like to share is about equity and balance. A dominant theme of both the Lusaka Declaration and the Windhoek Treaty. Because our countries are so disparate, Tanzania is so much bigger than Lesotho. Zimbabwe at that time was so much more developed than Botswana. Today, South Africa is that much bigger by volume, population, size of economy compared to Malawi. to achieve equity and balance, have we got instruments, capacities, and resources for the region to develop together in equity and balance to mitigate the disparities among us? Those were the questions we confronted in 1980 at the formation of the organization. Are they questions we still confront today, 40 years down the road? If I follow President Mukapa's presentation this morning, he suggests we still confront those issues. But to your question, sir, I was privileged to serve SADC through three phases. It was the formative years. I was the first substantive executive secretary of SADC because my predecessor died 6 months after he was appointed. So we went through establishment. First 5 years to get the organization running, a modest secretariat of 13 people, and a much bigger number of people operating in SADC in the member states, because we operated under the decentralized sector of coordination structure. After establishment, we consolidated the coordination activities that we were pursuing at the time, mainly transport and communications, energy, agriculture, and food security. And then we went through the third phase of transformation from the coordination conference to the community. In fact, bringing out the Vindu Treaty and its approval in 1992 was among the last activities that I executed as executive secretary. Whether they are achievements or not, I leave for you to